More grace, everybody. My name is Teresa Iyama. I come here to testify what God has done for my son. So last 2 weeks, my son called me. He did Italy. He said he want cross, go France. He want go France. I begin to pray. So last week, he go. He said he want go. He call his dad. He said he want come out. He call come out. As he come out now, police, they arrest him. They carry him to deport a cap. So we begin to pray. They pray. God, have mercy. So that was Sunday. My husband, he called my daughter. He said, see, oh, make una begin to pray. Oh, may they release your brother. Say yes, we begin to pray. So when I call church, we call church. My daddy, the Lord, senior pastor P.I.A. Obaseki, he say, may they come out, may you come and sow a seed. If you know what you want, may God do for you. May you come out, cause sow a seed. My daughter run come out. He calls sow a seed. He say, in what make the release his brother. Now see her just now where they show her. So he pull hand for her head. He pray for her. He claim it. He go sit down. So we begin to pray. They pray. On Monday evening, he called. That my son, he called. He say, Daddy, the daughter is me. I don't day fresh.
Okay, go ahead. You have what to say, madam? Okay, let me hear you. Thank you.
God bless everybody.
From glory to glory.
My name is Blessed Baba Hai. I'm here to return the glory to God Almighty. On Sunday morning, my dad called me, said, Mama, they pray for your brother. He just they call and now say, the door arrest town. Now I say, how? Where in they go, where they arrest, I no get paper. He say, they go meet my sister for France. And I say, well, God will take control. As I come out, I enter my room. I carry air from above, anointing oil. I use an anointing picture. I say, Omo, you are released. You are discharged and acquitted. Then I leave the picture there. I carry the other one. I come church. When daddy called a lead prayer, say, what do you want, may God do for you. So I sit down for my seat. I be no one comment. So suddenly they tell me, say, get up. I'll chuck hand for my pocket. I'll remove my hand. I'll chuck hand about 3 times. I chuck hand for pocket. I remove my hand. My junior one will sit down near me because say, sister, come out. Shall you tell me, say, they arrest brother? I said, nah, so. Now, with that boldness, I call come out. I call sow that seed. Daddy call and say, what do you want may God do for you? Now I say, I want my brother to be released. He say, he's discharged and acquitted. Really, I claim her. For my mind, I say, I carry a picture, call show you. You they lay hand for my head. Now picture I want may you lay hand put. So, now I say, if they talk and say, as far as they don't lay hand for our head. And it, as far as they don't lay hand for our head, that picture, whoa. The prayer reach on. So now I go sit down. On Monday of feet, as I come back from my market, now my dad say, my pikin shake me. Now I shake her. Already my mom don't know what they happen. Because if you tell her, she go they panic. Then let me and my dad with that our last born and no. So I call keep her between myself. Later on, never reach 30 minutes, my brother y'all call my dad, say, they don't release them, more help and they thank God, though. They don't release them. Now I say, glory be to God. Now I say, I want to hear his voice, whether I need to true call. Really, they give me the voice, I thought to them. Now his voice I hear. Say that my sister, help me, they thank God, though. They don't release me. Now today will come give the testimony.
Yes, that's a wonderful one. Yes. For the sake of those who don't understand Pidgin English, the son to Mama, who is in Italy, who is a brother to our sister here, was arrested while he was crossing from Italy to France. The policeman arrested him and sent him down to deportation camp. Then he called his father. Baba, I have been arrested. So the father now called her first daughter and said, look, your brother is arrested. Go and pray. So, and they hide it from their mother because their mother panic over little things so that she would not attract hypertension. So, she used the anointing oil from this ministry to anoint the photograph of the brother. I called the brother's name and said, you are free. Then, when she came to the service, prophetic service last Wednesday, she came with the photograph. It came to a time I was leading prayer and calling everyone, come forward. If you know you have anything you want God to do for you, come now and tell me here before the altar and I will lay hand on you. She came forth and I asked her, what do you want God to do for you? He said, I want my brother to be released. Then I laid my hand upon his head and said, he is discharged and acquitted. She went back home and she dropped her seed. Then she went back. There was a trouble in her mind that she expected me to lay hand on the photograph, not her head. Listen, when a man of God lays hand on your head, everything you carry is affected. If you are in the service and you come before me and lay hand on you, your bag is there. Everything inside your bag is affected. So, by the grace of God Almighty, going back home, shortly the brother called and said he has been discharged and acquitted. Now he made his journey to France successfully. Shall we give a clap of praise to Jesus Christ? When you are arrested in Europe and sent to deportation camp, they don't release you like that. Oh, you have to go and take a lawyer. It is lawyer that fights the battle. But listen, here, the little seed she sowed fought the battle by grace. That's the truth. You never can tell the day God will attend to your issue. And that is why, when you are in church, be attentive to everything. Because a moment is enough for God to settle you. Tell your neighbor, congratulations. So we give thanks to God for what he has done for this family, for not allowing you run up and down. And today you are testifying to the glory of God. We bless the name of the Lord. To God be the glory. Now, sister, what advice have you to give to your viewers today?
My advice to the viewers is, have faith in God and believe. Nothing too hard for God to do. Just have faith.
So what advice have you to give to some doubting Thomas? Some people, no matter how you pray for them, they still look at your face and are so rich. Just like you. You were expecting me to lay hand on the photograph. You were still waiting. They had to say, you go. Yeah, I pray for you. Those doubting Thomas, what advice have you to give them?
The advice I have for them, don't doubt your mind. As far as God has led the man of God to pray for you, to prophesy to you, just believe, grab it, and God will work for you.
It is well with you. God bless you. Mama, what advice have you to give to your viewers today, to the glory of God?
The advice I have for all viewers. Be patient. Now, patient, and be everything. Patient.
Thank you. God bless you. Grace be unto you in Jesus' name. When you know that God is on your side, trouble not yourself. God bless you in Jesus' name.
Assignment concerning your life. concerning your children, concerning your job, concerning your marriage, concerning your future. Holy Ghost!